Imagine that Sherlock Holmes traded his magnifying glass for a Python code and became a data scientist. Join me in this visual guide as we explore the intersection of solving a crime with probability using Bayes' theorem. So our hypothetical situation goes as follows. Watson says, "Sherlock, I think there is someone behind our curtains." Then Sherlock replies, "What's your evidence?" "I heard some noise coming from behind the curtains." "That's a piece of very strong evidence, Watson. Based on that evidence, what is the probability that there is someone behind our curtains?" "Well, I trust my senses, so I would say the probability that there is someone behind our curtains is 85%. Now, let's visualize that. Based on the evidence Watson experienced that he heard some noises, he thinks that the probability there is someone behind the curtains is 85%.
Wrong. You are too influenced by the evidence you have just found. Don't assess your evidence in isolation from everything else. You need to get some perspective, Watson. Let's have a thought experiment. Before hearing the noise, like prior to the current evidence, can you estimate the probability that there is someone behind our curtain?
So what Sherlock tries to say here is let's step back a bit and think about the context. How probable that there is someone hiding behind the curtains to start with, regardless of any piece of evidence?
What do you mean? Do you want me to go back in time, pretending that I didn't hear any noises, and think of the probability that there is someone behind our curtain? Exactly that. It's not easy, especially after you already hear the noises, but give it a try. It will give you some perspective. Well, although it's not that common, we send lots of bad people to prison. Therefore, I would say that there is 10% probability that there is some lunatic behind our curtains.
So now this 10% represents the probability that there is someone behind the curtains, regardless of any noises or evidence Watson noticed. In Bayesian statistics, we call this the prior, also known as the probability of the hypothesis being true. By the way, if the word hypothesis intimidates you, just think of it as the word theory for now. So the probability that the theory is true, that there is someone behind the curtains, is 10%, regardless of any evidence. Then Sherlock continues,
"The next step, given that theory is true, that there is someone behind our curtain, what is the probability of hearing noises from behind the curtains?" Well, depending on how clumsy the person is and how much they want to hide it, I would say roughly 60%.
So what Watson says here is that let's assume that there is someone behind the curtains. The probability of that person making any noise is about 60%. Now notice that this 60% is 60% out of the 10%, which is very slim.
See? Having someone behind our curtains is not that common to start with. Only 10%. And of that 10%, there is a 60% probability that the evidence might occur. See how perspective is important and context is key? We haven't finished yet. Now, let's assume that your theory is false, like no one behind the curtains. What is the probability of hearing noises behind the curtains? Like false positive.
What Sherlock tries to say is that let's assume that we are wrong and there is no one behind the curtains. Given that, what is the probability of us hearing noises from behind there?
And Watson replies, it could be a cat or something. So I would say there is 20% probability that I would hear noises from behind the curtains, given that there is no one is there.
If the blue shades is the 90% representing the theory is wrong, the 18 white X's are the 20% that illustrate that we hear noise, given that the theory is wrong.
Then Sherlock continues, so given that the theory is wrong, no one behind the curtains, there's 20% of that 90% that you can hear noises from behind the curtains. So you're telling me, given the evidence, the probability that there is someone behind the curtains is 6 out of 24, which equals 25.
Now, since we experience the evidence, meaning that we heard the noise from behind the curtain, we will count all the X's regardless of whether the theory is right or wrong. We get 24 X's. 6 X's of these 24 represent that the theory is correct, meaning that there is someone behind the curtains. And 18 out of these 24 represent that the theory is wrong. There is no one behind the curtains. This can be presented mathematically using the famous Bayesian equation, where the probability that the hypothesis is true given the evidence, meaning the probability of there is someone behind the curtains given hearing the noises, equals to the following. First, the probability of the theory being true regardless of any evidence, meaning there is someone behind the curtains regardless of hearing any noises. Then, we will multiply that by the probability of the evidence given the hypothesis is true, meaning the probability of hearing the noises given that there is someone behind the curtains. Then all of that is divided by the probability of the evidence itself, regardless of the hypothesis, meaning the probability of hearing noises from behind the curtains, whether or not there is someone behind the curtains. And that translates to 25%. And as you can see, the denominator is the red area. So if we clip the red area, we end up with 6 orange squares out of 24 squares. And that's the 25%. And that's the new belief. 25 instead of 85. Do you think Sherlock will let that slip? Of course not. So he says,
"And you thought it's 85%, you pathetic. That was uncalled for. I'll update my old belief, the prior, from 85 to 25, the posterior."
And since you made it this far, I want to share with you a Python code that can calculate this probability. Check the code in the description below. If you like this content, please subscribe and smash the like button. See you next time.